Today we're in Wilmington, New York. On August the 20th, we will be celebrating the Bicentennial for Wilmington, New York. How you doing?
Doing pretty good.
Well, now that looks spectacular.
Like an old Adirondacker.
Yeah. Can you tell me?
It's pretty much the way I dress most of the time anyway.
That's
Yeah.
got him. And I'd like to thank you all for coming out and celebrating with us. Thank you.
did a tremendous amount of work. We were working 8, 10, and 12-hour days to get it done. We found photos at 450. We added 400 new photos to our collection. People literally took photos down on their walls, the singular photos that don't exist anywhere else. They scanned them and let us add them to our collection, and those are in the book.
The more we found,
the more we wanted, the more we did. it was a labor of love, and a tremendous amount of work and a great deal of research, and it was accurate research. So three of us actually did the writing. Guy was on the other end of the phone doing a tremendous amount of research for us, and giving us dates and places and names and all kinds of stuff.
So it's Wilmington's story, the first 200 years.
Yes.
That sounds like a good subject for a documentary film.
It is. And it's
to be continued.
And that's what it says at the back. And that's what this is. Because these are our future historians. And so when we do this, we are creating future historians.
Yeah.
So for the next 200 years, it's going to be these kids. When we do that project.
So the kids made these presentations?
Yes. Each historical society brought artifacts.
Hello there. How are you doing, Mike?
We spread them out on a table. The kids had a lot of artifacts to choose from. They chose the artifacts that they wanted to research. So they researched the artifact itself. They measured it. They weighed it. They did research on how it was used and that kind of thing. And then they researched the person behind it. So for example, that fly fishing rod and reel, it just so happened that the rod that the kids had was from the Lake Placid North Elba Historical Society, but the student who did that was Fran Bedder's a descendant of Fran Bedder's. And he was so excited to do that project. So obviously he ended up talking about Wilmington, and he's very excited. This is Jeannie Ashworth. Jeannie Ashworth, as a child, competed here in Wilmington, New York, believe it or not. And we have those two medals in our artifacts collection. And the kids love that one. And they researched her, and they got to research speed skating itself, plus her, and all of that. And then they have to present their project to the class. So it ends up being like they create a mini museum.
Well, that's really nice.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, I'm Guy Stevenson. I'm one of the founding members of the Wilmington Historical Society. And this will be our second book we've done since we've been an organization. It's a lot of work, but it's well worth it.
I'm Judy Lawrence, and I'm just a member doing my job.
and an author of this book.
Oh, I am an author of this book, right.
Wilmington's story, the first 200 years.
Karen Marshall Peters. My ancestors hail from Wilmington since the early 1800s. I'm president of the Historical Society. I'm a retired teacher, so I'm enjoying doing my second career job. Well, except this one's for free. It becomes a volunteer position after that. So, an author of the book.
Vice President of the Historical Society, town historian, retired postmaster. My husband and I are both descendants of early settlers to the area. The best way to do your genealogy is to do it all.
Amen to that. In fact, I met this whole group of people through you.
That's right.
Originally, you were performing at the park.
The praise band at the farmer's market.
A miracle.
Farmer's
one introduction
market.
And a little bit of friendliness goes a long way.
It does.
How many of you
here with me, Gib Brown and Mary Minogue. June couldn't be here with us. We had a couple gift cards that were donated to us by Iron Man. So the first gift card is a $100 gift card, and that is going to go to the Wilmington Volunteer Fire Department.
I live here in Wilmington. My name's Bill McGreevy. And I'm thrilled to be here just because Sadie's here.
Oh, you're such a bomb.
Yeah.
So, I'm Sadie Hosley and I'm from Wilmington.
Mike Bringley.
Well, Mr. Clark, good morning. How are you? Good.
Where'd you come from?
Paula McGreevy. Brooke Terry's.
Hi. Bill Hosley.